Hey everybody, it's Norm from Tested here at this year's Bricks by the Bay. Now, I'm joined by Zach. You have a setup here in the military zone, and it's drawing a lot of attention because you have a mechanized tank. Tell me about this Abrams tank.
This Abrams tank is a variant of the Abrams chassis. It's a M1074 JAB, Jab Joint Assault Bridge, and it's a replacement for the AVLB bridge launching system that the U.S. Army is currently fielding right now. And I think it's just in production. It's not very well known in like the military community, or at least I don't see too many military Lego builds of it. But I'm pretty sure if you research it on Wikipedia, you'd find it there. M1074 Jab Joint Assault Bridge.
So you're not just going for, of course, the aesthetic accuracy of the tank, and it sounds like you guys definitely know a lot about this specific model. You're going for the functional accuracy. It deploys an actual bridge.
Yeah. The functionality is the more important part for me. I actually have like this smaller version of my Jab. That was an Abrams tank with a bridge launching system. I've had that for a while, right? But it wasn't really military accurate because originally the AVLB was going to be replaced by the Wolverine platform, which is a German-based bridge launching system. But the United States ended up going with a Abrams chassis with a scissor bridge type launching system.
So the scissor bridge launching system, it folds up. I saw it's almost like over two times the length of the actual tank itself.
Yep.
And then there's a lot of precise control needed to get it to deploy over this chasm.
Yeah, it does take a lot of precise control. You got to get your gear ratios just right so you can slow down the motors. And then what also helps is the controller that I'm using for it, which is Sbrick. And it gives you fine tuned controlling for it.
And this is a controller that then connects to the existing LEGO power system, the motors.
LEGO power function motors, LEGO power functions battery. And I actually have an example that I could be showing you. This would be what an Sbrick would look like. And this one here, you get an extension cable, you plug it in here, and then you got four inputs, outputs. On my tank, it's running two Sbricks.
And then connects to an app on your phone,
which
as I saw you were controlling it, you were then very precisely moving the bridge, the lift, the main line.
Yeah. And this one here is a beta testing version. Sbrick has provided me this one just to really get some beta testers testing out the bugs. And then hopefully this comes out pretty soon. But they're not giving out any real dates just yet.
So it's like scratch based, drag and drop.
Yeah. To be exact, I think this one here is a Google-based block coding system, Blockly.
Got it. Very cool. What were the technical challenges? You made one of the first ones. Maybe it was a shorter bridge.
Yep.
What are the challenges of getting this reliable?
That one there is, it's definitely a bit of a challenge. Even today, I ran it about 30 times, broke about two times.
Is it in the studs that are disconnecting or the misalignment?
A combination of each. First, it was some of the Technic pins that I installed there. Fell out, and then sometimes the fishing line would break, but it only happened once with the fishing line. Right now, the fishing line that I got on it, that's just actuating the lifting of the main bridge, really, is 50 pounds, rated for 50 pounds, and I'm thinking after today I might go up to 100 pounds.
That's really, really impressive. What's next for you? Are you building more tanks, more military-style Lego? Is that your passion?
Yeah, my passion is really a lot of military base tanks. I've been doing that for years, and I have a lot of 1/24th scale tanks, and I've been moving into 1/16th like this one. Originally I had this one set up as an Abrams tank. I published that a couple months ago, and then when I brought this one out, I wanted a bridge that could support the weight of this one, and so I had to upscale.
It's one of those things that when you see it working, it's like, I didn't think Lego can do that, have the tolerances and that fine control, and it works almost perfectly every time.
Yeah. I mean, it's a lot of technical challenges, and I kind of have seen like everywhere it could fall apart, and it's like, okay, I know how to fix this quickly and rapidly so I can be presenting it to the public today.
It's a real bit of engineering. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.